Hi, I'm Ollie Hooper, a quantitative developer at QuantConnect, and this is Idea Streams, a weekly video series where we test an idea derived from current market trends by building a training strategy on QuantConnect. In this week's Idea Streams, I thought I'd give it a bit more of a Christmas spin and have a look at a seasonal investing strategy. So the rationale behind this investment strategy is that typically consumer cyclical stocks such as e-commerce websites or retailers are undervalued pre-sale and pre-Christmas season. So what we're expecting is to buy these in November and hopefully they beat their earnings estimates or they have been undervalued. So we see a rise in the stock price and then we sell them in February or March time. So let's have a look at implementing this strategy. So we've got a clean algorithm here and there are going to be two states of this strategy. We are either going to be in consumer cyclical stocks or we're going to be in the general market, so just using a S&P 500 tracker. So we want to keep this, and we're going to call this self.market, and we're going to take the symbol from it, and we're going to use daily resolution for this. Okay, next, we want to actually get our consumer cyclical stocks. So the way that we're going to do that is we're going to use a universe selection function, which takes in fundamental data, which has the sector that the stock is in. So let's go into our data library and fundamentals. And let's also open another documentation tab and head to universe selection. So we're going to use fundamental universe selection. Let's just take this and add it here. Okay, so this has given us two extra functions which we're going to use. So our course selection function and our find selection function. So our core selection function has price and volume data coupled with it. So we don't really need to use this function. And so we can just pass through course. However, our find function is what we're going to use to sort our consumer cyclical stocks. So if we head back into our fundamentals data documentation, we can go down to asset classification and have a look what they've done here. So they've got X for X and fine if the sector equals this sector code. So we're actually going to borrow this list comprehension here and paste it into here. Oh, there we go. And we want the consumer cyclical sector code. So here we've got a table with the sector codes and we can see here the sector code is 102, or we can just pass in this consumer cyclical class. There we go. So this means that this find selection function is going to return all of the consumer cyclical stocks that are passed through the course universe. So let's just do a tiny bit of filtering on this. And let's say that we want to, so remember we need to do x dot symbol here and therefore c dot symbol. Let's just do a quick sort and say that we want stocks that have a price greater than 5 just to sort through the penny stocks in course if c.price is greater than 5. Okay, so this is going to give us, this universe selection is going to give us all of the consumer cyclical stocks. So as I said, there are going to be two states of this algorithm. So let's create two functions to execute those states. So let's first have one called into market. Let's take self. And in this function, what we want to do is basically first just liquidate our stocks, make sure we've got clean slate, and then buy into the market. So self.setholdings, self.market, so that's the S&P 500 tracker we've got here, and just make that all of our holdings. Okay, and also we want to know which state we're in. So let's create a flag up here called self.inconsumer, and let's default it to true. And so at the bottom here, if we do self.inConsumer, we are now false as we're now into the general market. Okay, and our second state here is going to be into consumers. So self, and we also want to take through a list of securities. So a list of the consumer securities that we want to be invested in. So again, let's create a clean slate here, and then let's loop through these securities and set our holdings so that we're equally weighted. So S, and then do 1 divided by the length of securities. There we go. And so now let's just let our flag know that we're into consumer. So let's set this to true. So there we've got our two states of the algorithm. We're either equally weighted in consumer cyclical stocks in November through to March, or we're into the market as a whole. So let's also define these months that we want up here. So let's go self.consumerMonths, just in case we want to change these around, and let's make it November, December, January, February, and March. There we go. Okay, so let's head into our onData method. So we can just get rid of these comments here. And the first thing that we're going to do is check whether we're in the months that we're meant to be in the consumer stocks. So if self.time.month is in self.consumerMonths. And actually, we want to check if we're not in those. So if we should be in the general market, let's start off with that. So this checks that the current month is a non-consumer month, so just a general market month, so anywhere between April and October. And then let's check if this is the first time, so if this is the first trading day in March, then our self.inconsumer, sorry, first trading day in April, our self.inconsumer should actually be true, as it hasn't been changed yet. So this means that we can execute our self.intoMarket method, and then this will mean that whenever onData is triggered again and we're still in this April through to October period, we'll pass this first if statement, but we won't pass the second. And this means that we only trade once into the market. We're not trading every single day, you know, liquidating our SPY holdings and then rebuying it. Okay. And so if this isn't the first time, then we can just sit back, let our SPY holdings do the work, and simply just return here. Okay, so let's say that it is currently during the consumer period, so during November through to March. So this is where we end up here, as we would have returned if it wasn't. So in our data slice here, we should have a list of all of the securities which are consumer cyclical securities. So let's just do a quick sort. So S for S in data.keys. If S does not equal our market symbol. So this is just to make sure that we don't end up accidentally investing into SPY during our consumer months. Okay, so that gets us our list of securities there. Okay, so now that we've got that list of securities, let's actually check that we have some securities in there. And if not, we'll just return. So if length of securities is less than 1, then we're just going to return. Another condition where we won't want to continue is if we are currently in the in-consumer period. So, or our self.inconsumer is true. So we don't want to keep on rebalancing our portfolio. Once we have bought into the consumer cyclical stocks at the start of November, we're just going to leave them there until we sell those and then move into the market in April. So also, just for the start, in case we start this algorithm during consumer months, we just want to check that our portfolio is invested. Because then if it's not invested, then as we default self.inconsumer to true, we want to make sure that we actually buy into those securities to start off with and not wait until the November of that year to go again. So we've made those conditions, which will just return and not do anything if that is the case. And so anywhere past this point, this will be the first time in the consumer period that we are going to trade into the consumer stocks. So what we can do here is just do self.intoConsumer and pass in this list of securities. Great. And so that's it for our onData method. So another thing that we want to just clean up here is in this select course method. So this universe selection function will be ran every day. And actually, to make sure that it runs every day, we can make a universe settings and make sure that the resolution is daily. So resolution.daily up in our initialize function. Okay, and so this is quite a taxing process, sorting through all of these fine objects will take quite a long time. So we want to minimize when this function is called. So we don't want this function to be called when we're not in our in-consumer period, and we also don't want it to be called when we're already invested in our consumers. So we can actually just take this if statement down here. So if we're not in the consumer period, or we are in the consumer period and we're invested, that's when we just want to return an empty list of securities so that doesn't continue any further. Great, so that should hopefully drastically improve the time that it takes our algorithm to take. So let's have a look at running a backtest now, and we want to get as long a period as we can, as it's quite an infrequent trading strategy. So it only, you know, changes its trades twice a year. So let's start this back in 2000. So 1st January 2000. So let's get a backtest running on this and see how it performs. Okay, so as we can see, our algorithm has finished its backtest since 2000. And we can see that the performance is a 660% return over this 20-year period. And let's have a look at the Sharpe ratio. So we have a Sharpe ratio of 0.539. Okay, so these numbers don't really mean much unless we compare it to a benchmark. So let's see if this actually beats holding the S&P 500 since 2000. So I've already run a backtest for this, and we can see that it has most certainly beaten it by quite a large amount. So we can see that just holding the S&P 500 for the past 20 years would give us a 270% return and a Sharpe ratio of 0.39. So if you look at annual numbers, we can see on the right side here that the annual return is 6.44%. And for our strategy, it was 10.146%. Let's also check that our strategy has worked as we expected. So let's go into our orders and let's have a look here. So we can see on the 1st of January, this should be in our consumer period. And thus we've bought these consumer cyclical stocks. So we can see Amazon in there at a nice cheap price there of $81. And so we can see that our algorithm is equally weighting our consumer cyclical stocks. Now, if we increase this, so now if we actually download these orders and view them as an Excel file, that'll allow us to just a bit more easily filter through them. And so let's create a filter on here and have a look at what dates there are. So yeah, we can see the 1st of January 2000 and then the 1st of April. So that's when we're going to move into the market. So if we deselect those and only select this one, we should just see selling all of our stocks. Yep, there we go. So minus and buying the SPY tracker. And let's just check the rest of the dates. Yep, 11th, so November, April. So they're all November and April. So our algorithm is working as we expected. Great. So it looks like our rationale at the start does have a bit of truth behind it. However, as our strategy is quite infrequent, you should always take this as a pinch of salt. And we can also see that the Sharpe ratio isn't that great compared to other strategies, but it is better than just the market on its own. So with all of that in mind, I hope you now have a better idea of how to create a seasonal investing strategy and also how to sort your stocks by sector using the fundamental universal selection methods. If you'd like clarification on any of these points or have any general queries, please do not hesitate to reach out. Both the team here at QuantConnect and the whole Quant community, which is now well over 100,000 strong, are valuable resources. And if you want to put this idea or any other idea to the test, check out Quant League, a weekly rolling competition where the quants in the community put their alphas to the test to win a share of a $1,000 cash prize pool. I hope you have a Merry Christmas, and until I see you next time, happy coding.